we have not told anybody our name, so you only get to know our name by coming to this gig. It's like a VIP thing. But we have started a band called Honeyluck. Don't tell anyone.
You can follow us on Instagram. We haven't posted literally anything, but please follow us on Instagram.
Yeah, eventually there will be content. But these are some songs that we wrote. We're all best friends. After this, we're all going to get an apartment together and maybe a reality show.
And College Station.
Thank you.
Thanks for being here on a Sunday, y'all. Skipping church. For those of you who go to church at 4:30. There's got to be a 4:30 service somehow.
Oh, there is. That's about it.
Midnight.
guitar. Hey, Richard, wait a sec. Can I get a little more of my vocal in the monitor, please? Thank you. That was obviously not a song we wrote. First two were, and then this one is too. This is a song about love and about feeling all weird when you see someone for the first time across the room and you feel like kind of sick. Like they're so cute, you're sick. This one's called Vertigo.
They're so cute, you're sick?
They're so cute, you're sick with Vertigo.
Love that for us.
This song is called I Miss the Music in Austin.
I miss the music in Austin. A patio lights and a simple song for new friends. I miss the music in Austin.
Actually shot the music video for that song right here on the stage. So if you want, you can look that one up online. I'm going to do another shameless plug because we literally have zero followers on the internet yet because we're a brand new band that we haven't told anybody about until right now. So if you want to check out your phones, you can follow Honey Love Music. We haven't posted anything and it looks like a fake account, but it's not. So
Honey Love
Music.
Honey Luck.
Nine followers, yes!
Well, we're famous.
That makes me so happy.
Also, Honey Love is a very different account.
That's your brand.
I mean, I follow it. I'm not saying, I'm not judging. I'm just saying. When we were deciding what songs to play, so we've written like five or six songs by ourselves. Not by ourselves, you know what I mean. We wrote them together. We were trying to figure out how best to play an hour set and turn all five songs into 20-minute solos was quickly shot down. So we started going through our own, you know, personal catalogs. I have my own, you know, solo project, and then of course Jordan and Kayla are married, and then Beth James, which is one of my favorite bands in Austin, that I so much so that I invited myself to join. And they're like, well, let's just make our own band. I said, all right. But we were looking at our catalogs, trying to think about what to play, and then we got this gig here at the Saxon Pub, which is my favorite place in the entire world. And I started looking at my catalog, thinking about what I could play, and God bless them, they started suggesting songs for us to play that I wrote, which was so nice and cool to know that your friends listen to your songs. But then I got to one of them and I was like, oh yeah, if we don't play this, Jolene won't let us come back anymore. I have to play this song every time we're here or Jolene spits in my drink. This is a song about Fayetteville, Arkansas. I will give you the abridged version of the story, but I wrote this with Grace Pettis at a bar called JR's Lightbulb Club.
Grace.
If you don't know Grace, Grace is the best. She's a really, really great songwriter, a really good friend. Go look up Grace. But we played a Tuesday night gig at JR's Lightbulb Club in Fayetteville, Arkansas. There was nothing else to do in Fayetteville, Arkansas on a Tuesday night except drink a ton of well liquor, which was free at the bar for the performance. So Grace got really drunk, and she's laying down in the booth singing Patty Griffin songs poorly, and she sees these two chandeliers, and one of them has all but one light out, and the other one has all but one light still lit. And so Grace was pretty hammered, so she thought that was poetic. And the next morning I was drinking Gatorade, that fancy kind that's got all the electrolytes and shit in it. And Grace walks out in like full yoga pants, you know, Dr. Soul's shoes or whatever, just ready for a walk, and I'm immediately pissed. And I just didn't want to talk. I just had the guitar. I clearly had like, please don't talk to me, written across my forehead. And she accosted me into writing this song, which to this day is still one of the nicest things that anybody has ever done for me. This is called Chandelier.
Just kids with my hands around.
I'm not afraid to Jordan Benchel on electric guitar, everybody.
I take back the thing I said about the mustache. That was kick-ass. You can go to whatever 13-year-old girl camp you want.
I hate you so much.
Speaking of...
look at your nice haircut, though.
I know, it's good, right? Perfect.
Your haircut is the most corporate haircut. It's like your, it's like a lawyer haircut.
I literally took a printout picture of Ryan Gosling to the barbershop.
Oh, really?
Like, we can't do this. You can have the hair, but...
Yeah, I'll go to the barbershop.
Speaking of giving credit where credit was due, I do want to acknowledge Brian Christopher Mendez, Gregory Hagen are the best. I don't know how many, I know a lot of you are actually songwriters. But when you like, when you finally hire a band, you normally have like a record, the parts are set, you've got something going on. And this band was made with like us three at their house around an iPhone, and then we sent it to Brian and Greg and like, here, make some music out of this. And they just fucking killed it, man. So please, they deserve all the applause in the world. Put your hands together for Brian Christopher Mendez and Gregory Hagen over here, doing all the hard work. We also have a tip jar if you want to show your appreciation in a monetary form. Greatly appreciated. All right.
Well, I ought to be working in a coal mine, neck deep in black long sleeves. Swinging a pit down the mountainside, halfway to China. I think I will be drowning in where the sun don't shine. She's better off alone. Well, I won't be working in a coal mine. Lord knows I'm gonna be a deep hole. Well,
So awesome.
And I was young yesterday. I didn't care about the sun. Hiding my face, I would turn away. Like a small town thief on the run. But now I'm upset. Yeah, again. Oh,
to say, I know Dave said it, thank you guys so much for coming. It's so great to see familiar faces and also new faces. And thank you so much for Saxon for having us. I always love playing Saxon. It's one of my favorite places in the world. So thank you. Come back. Yeah.
It's also weird to play in front of people.
Yeah.
We usually have just done this in mostly our living rooms. Like you said, just gathering around a tiny phone. But again, please come back. We're writing all the time. We're writing more songs. And there's going to be new ones each time. And this one is actually the first song we ever wrote together, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So
I got the opportunity to go over to a friend's house and record a song. And I didn't have anything new written. And I needed some folks that were really talented, really good, could play a bunch of stuff, and would also do it for free. We kind of got together and was like, hey, this is a low-risk opportunity. Might as well try something. And we wrote this song. And within, like, for me, I don't know when y'all knew, but within, like, 15 minutes, I was like, this is something special that I want to be a part of.
Right.
So this was the tune that we made.
Little sweat protector. It's like Under Armour for guitar slide. All right.
Y'all come back next Sunday, stick around.